Don't play with her, don't be dishonest. Ay, still not understanding. Hey guys, it's Blixis and welcome back to my channel. You guys have been asking me how do I make clothes from scratch. So I've done a couple on a different account, but I didn't keep the shop up for long. So let's get into it. Basically gonna want to derive from items that look like this. The name of the account is WIING. So it all is very.
What? Bro, what are you talking about, man?
Varies from what exactly you're trying to make. Let's take a look at her shop. She literally have a whole bunch of things you can derive from. Literally. So today we're gonna make a dress. She have the templates here that you can download. You're gonna be like, oh, it look mad complicated. It's not too shabby. It's not too shabby. She do got a lot of shit up here, not gonna lie. Okay, so we're gonna take this one. And we're gonna take the back. I feel like that's all we really need, to be honest. What we're gonna be using today, what I always use, Ibis Paint X, which is okay. I'll just do it from scratch. So we're gonna take this right here. I'm gonna take the back. You're gonna find a dress you wanna make. Let me just airdrop one to my iPad. It's gonna look a little blurry because it's a small dimension. We're just gonna take that. I'm gonna remove the background. I did it wrong. That's gonna have to do. So basically what you want to do, you want to line it up with the template like so. Move tool. I didn't really use this. I used this dress to create on SL, not on VU. So I'm actually doing everything from scratch. Try and line it up as good as possible. Okay, see, we're gonna have to you can use a drag tool and just fix that. Erase the parts like this that you don't need. Let me see how I look. Okay, that's good. You don't. Okay, let me think. Hide this layer. Make a new one. Drag it all the way down. Fill it with black. Then you could put that back. I'm gonna erase all the. Erase all that excess. Like so. Some of it don't matter because it's not going to show with the opacity map. I'm trying to make this as fast and as clear as possible.
All right. You're gonna save this. And then what you're gonna do, you're gonna go here and go to invert and make it so it's a white opacity map. You're gonna save that. And then go back. I'm gonna click this one so you can see the back part. I don't have the back of the dress, so we're just gonna use the front as the back of the dress. Make sure everything lines up perfectly. Take this away. And I guess you can just invert, save. I'm gonna send it to my laptop and I'll show you guys how it look. When it comes to making clothes, I suggest getting a hanger so you can probably see the clothes. Okay, so this is how it looks. I'm gonna show you guys how to remove all the unnecessary things, like these bottoms. What you want to do is go to the opacity map and you want to just put an all black texture on it. No, not that one. Like so. Go to the next one. That's the bottoms. Put the black texture. I gotta see if this is the front or the back. We're gonna have to play around with it a little bit because it can be tricky. So we're gonna remove all of this first. So this is how it looks when you remove all the bullshit that you don't need. So skin tight top. So this is not a dress, this is the top. So we're gonna make that black. I'm gonna make this black as well. And then this is what we got focused on. So you wanna put the actual dress. You wanna put the actual dress here under the fuse. Since it's the same thing we made, it's gonna be in the same column. And then for the opacity map, you're gonna put the white with the black background. Y'all, I just woke up. All right, we're gonna see how it looks. It may look a little off and then we're gonna have to go back and fix it. Also, when you're deriving from the clothes, make sure you use the body size. So this is, I'm sure this is like RL. So I believe she has like different kinds of sizes. So this is the front. You see how this part isn't matching the front of the dress. We're gonna have to do, I'm gonna insert the clip. What we're gonna have to do is flip the back piece. So that's what I'm just gonna do. I'm just gonna quickly do it. So here we are back on the iPad. What we're gonna do is just flip it horizontally like that. I'm gonna save that and go to invert. We're gonna save that and then send it to your computer. We're gonna put in a new, okay, there it is. We're gonna put in a new texture and opacity map like so. Girl, no, not like that. Don't do that. And let's see the difference in the dress. There we go. Now that's looking a little better. So that's basically all that it really is for when it comes to working with opacity maps. You can take your time to perfect it. This was just a quick tutorial to show you the basics. I might do like classes where I can go on a Zoom with you guys and teach you right there and then, and you guys can ask me any questions you may have. Next video, I'll do like a shirt or something, or you can put in the comments what exactly you want me to show. I have another video coming about some of the questions you had about the chains. So in that video, I'll be answering all of your questions. If you have any questions about what I did here, you can always comment or text me on Instagram at shopblixis. And like, comment, subscribe, share the video with your peers, recommend me to your friends on VU, go into the chat rooms and be like, oh, you saw Blix's new video for chains and stuff? Yeah, you guys should really check her out. You know, hype me up a little bit. And I want to thank y'all for getting me to 100 subscribers, because without y'all, this wouldn't be possible. And God, of course. We're literally, let me check my phone. We're almost at 150. Hopefully by the end of, I want to say, I feel like the end of this month is a drag. So by the end of next month, hopefully 150 subscribers or 200 even. But yeah, thank you for watching. Let me know if you have any questions. Bye.